Marshmallow.
Alright, hello guys. So this video is going to be a little bit more on the serious side, as I say with marshmallows in my hands. It's going to be about anxiety and depression and hypertension and all that fun stuff. So if you guys don't know what anxiety is, well, bless you. Anxiety is basically hell. Anxiety is basically where you feel like you cannot breathe. No matter what, you mentally tell yourself you cannot breathe. Usually, you know, your body gets all tense, your arms are all heavy, your legs are all whatever, and it's like ridiculous, and you feel like you're gonna die. You feel sometimes, most people get pain in their chest, blah blah blah, but I don't really. So that's like, yeah. And there was a point in my life, probably 2 years ago, where I had really, really bad anxiety, like, really, really bad. Not just that, it was like so many other things, but I'll get onto that in like a few minutes here. Point is that I'm starting to feel the way I did at the worst stage, like, in my life ever. Like, I remember it today, and the thought of it is like terrible. I don't ever want to go back there, and I'm starting to feel that way again, so I thought I would make this video and talk to you guys, if that makes sense. I don't know. It's like what people do, you know? I've just been feeling really, like, vertigo, if you guys make sense. Fatigued, just out of it, lost, confused, I don't feel normal, I don't feel good, I just kind of want to, like, go swimming with sharks. You guys don't know what vertigo means. It's basically where you feel like you're gonna pass out every second. It's like you're just dizzy, you're confused, you don't know what's going on around you, and you're just so out of it, you're gone, I don't know. Anyways, the other night I had a panic attack, which was my first panic attack in, I want to say, like, a year or so. So that wasn't fun at all. No, that was terrible. And it reminded me just why I never want to be the person or be that way that I was ever again. Because I've seen, like, all kinds of anxiety, depression, blah 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 videos. But usually the people that are making those videos are, like, over, you know, like, they're past their anxiety and they're past their depression and they're, you know, happy. So it's like so hard to even take you seriously when you're talking about it all, because when you're going through anxiety or depression, yet you don't want to see people smile at you. So basically it wasn't really the fact that I had a panic attack that got to me, it's like, why did I have a panic attack? I've been really happy. Like, I haven't been stressed out, I haven't had anxiety since, like, longer than I can remember. I've been doing really good, and I thought I was over and past all of that, but no, out of nowhere it hit me. Like, I'm not gonna lie, a few weeks ago I was kind of depressed, I didn't want to get out of bed, and I was just feeling kind of like, just, I didn't care, basically, about anything. Kind of lost, because my doggie of, like, so many years just randomly went missing one night, and pretty sure coyotes had something to do with it, but that wasn't fun at all, so I was in a funk, but I got over it, you know, and I've been, like, doing everything that I've always wanted to do. I'm, like, working on becoming a nutritionist, blah blah blah, my fitness, blah blah blah, all that kind of stuff, and it's just been really good, and everything's been nice, except that had to happen, and now I'm kind of in, like, this little foggy world right now. And I know that I shouldn't, like, let it get to me, because it will eventually pass, just like it has every other time I've dealt with it, but it's like every time it happens, it's just so much worse than it was the last time. I don't know how to explain it. It's like I don't really want to put the effort into getting over it anymore. I'm just getting sick of it. I'm getting sick of it happening. It seems like every time I go and I get things in a good spot, or I get myself in a happy, woohoo position, whatever, it's like, no, you can't be happy. Basically, this video is just gonna be like my story, kind of like, you know, therapy session, I guess. But yeah, I'm not going to be, you know, one of those people that are gonna get a box of tissue and they're gonna, you know, let all their emotions out while you're in this video, because quite frankly, I don't feel that way. I don't really feel like sad and upset, like I need to cry, as much as I do angry and bad and that I need to punch somebody. Alright, so it was like November 2011 when I decided I was gonna be a vegetarian. Stupidest decision I have ever made. The reason I decided to become a vegetarian was because I read this stupid article on iansummerholder.com, and it had nothing to do with, like, being a vegetarian. It's just, it was animal related, and I was like, I don't want to eat animals, that's so sad. So I stopped eating meat completely. Okay, I'm just gonna, like, you know, go ahead and point out that I did the whole vegetarian thing completely wrong, absolutely like the worst possible way you could ever cut out meat. I just didn't eat meat. I didn't like, you know, start eating more vegetables or fruits. I just didn't eat meat. I ate anything and everything except for meat. I actually think that I use the vegetarian thing as an excuse to eat more bad for me, disgusting, nasty, ugh, food. Yeah, I was a very fat vegetarian. Ugh, that's another story for another time. So about 5 to 6 months after I became a vegetarian, I started having problems sleeping at night. I couldn't sleep longer than 2 hours. It didn't matter day or night. The reason was because I was waking up, like, panicking. I couldn't breathe. I felt like I was suffocating, and all day long it was the same. It was like I couldn't breathe, and I felt like I was gonna suffocate and die. But my mama took me to the doctor, and they said it was asthma. So woohoo, easy fix, give me an inhaler and one of those robot, like, breathing machine things, and I'll be good. Woohoo, you know, whatever. As I think it was actually making it worse. Whenever I used the inhaler, it just felt like it got worse because I didn't actually need an inhaler. So I was fatigued all the time. I hated it. I felt like my mind and my body were two completely different things. Like, I felt like I didn't have control of myself, and that always creeped me out. So I started, you know, getting really panicky, and eventually I started having really, really bad panic attacks. So remember the first panic attack I had? Oh, that was worse. It wasn't just a panic attack. It was a panic attack and a migraine all mixed up. True story. I really thought I was going to die. My mom had to take me to the hospital, and they gave me anti-anxiety medication and a muscle relaxer. So needless to say, before they were even done with the IV, I was pissed. Basically, the only thing they could find is that I had white cells in my blood. I don't know. I was anemic because I didn't eat meat. Shut up, okay? My mom's like, well, if you're gonna be a vegetarian, you have to do it right. So I was like, fine. And I started eating tofu because I thought, okay, that's the vegetarian meat. So I started eating tofu, whatever, for a while. I thought I was getting better. And at the point, obviously, I knew I had anxiety. I didn't know what anxiety was before then, so whatever. Panic attacks weren't as bad when I started eating tofu and all that. And the vertigo, whatever, it started to go away a little bit. And I was starting to feel good again. I was like, yeah, I'm happy, even though I still had anxiety every day. I have probably in my room somewhere, like, a basket full of Vicks. You know, like, the little Vapor? I don't know. Vicks. It's like minty. Your mom rubs it on you and stuff. Yeah, I have so many of those because when I couldn't breathe, I always had one, like, up stuck to my nose. I was like, really did help. Mint does help anxiety, and it just really helped me calm down and tell myself, I am breathing, idiot, you're breathing, stop being stupid, you're breathing. So yeah, I basically just got familiar with anxiety, you know, and waking up, not being able to breathe, going through the day, not being able to breathe, you know. Basically, I couldn't take more than like 2 or 3 breaths without like gasping all the time because I felt like it wasn't going down where it should, like it wasn't going where it's supposed to be, and nobody believed me. They're like, oh, you're breathing, it's all in your head. I just want to point out, that is the absolute worst thing you could ever say to anybody who has anxiety. You're telling them that everything you're feeling, even though yes it is, you are like mentally thinking that you can't breathe, you're basically telling them that they're wrong, that there's nothing wrong with them, even though there's obviously something wrong if you were dealing with anxiety. So that just really, really made me mad all the time when people were like, oh, it's just in your head. So it felt like things were better, even though they were still pretty crappy. Out of nowhere, I started getting really fatigued again. I just had no energy, couldn't do anything. Like, I couldn't even be awake for very long because I was so tired, I was so out of it, my head was spinning all the time, I was confused, I was lost, I was like just a little zombie. And I remember one night in particular, because this is still the night that I hate myself for more than anything in the world, because it's just, so basically, like, all of my family were here in my house. This is when I was going through really bad, like, I was shaky because of how bad I needed to have a panic attack, basically, if that makes sense. I don't know. If you have ever had a panic attack, you know how you're like, you just get really, really tense and you start like just freaking out. But like, I was trying to hold it back because I was like, I ain't gonna panic in front of them. Whatever. So point is, I went to town with my sisters, and basically I had four or five, maybe six panic attacks that night. It was like just a burst of confusion, fear, anger. Like, I needed to cry. I did cry a lot that night. Oh my god. And I couldn't do it anymore. Like, I felt like my body was going to collapse to the floor, and I felt like I was gonna die. Yeah, it was terrible. I just kept having panic attacks. They'd last for like 10 minutes and I'd calm down. And then of course it's like embarrassing because I just freaking, I don't know, but I remember when I got home, on the way home, overwhelming amount of emotions basically just kind of hit me, and that's what was happening all night, and I just bust out in tears, and I was like freaking out. So my sisters had to stop the car and like calm me down, and then like when I got home, all my family was there, all my sisters' boyfriends and like husbands and all of this, so I had to like walk through the house, and they're all just like staring at me as I go. I was just like, this is so embarrassing. I am a very proud person, so that just killed me a little bit. It's not like they were looking at me like, oh, how dare you. It was more of a, what's going on? It was cool though, because like basically everyone came back and, you know, made sure I was okay, so I liked that. I was like, so I'm blessed with such an awesome family. So it was terrible, and my sister shoved hot dog down my throat that night, and I started eating meat after that. Like, you know, everybody stayed up till like 4 in the morning out laughing and having a good time, blah blah blah. Well, not out, but like in our house. And all my family, except I was in my room just basically crying. I didn't want to go out there because I felt like I was going to have another panic attack and it was going to like ruin everybody's mood, it was going to ruin everybody's night. So I just stayed in my room and cried the entire time. After that night, I don't want to say that I was depressed, but I was depressed. I just felt so angry at myself. I felt so bad and so like helpless, and it just felt like nothing was ever getting better and it was never going to get better. I thought that I was going to have to live like that for the rest of my life, so I basically didn't want to get out of bed at all. I'd wake up and I was like, right when I wake up, I was like just mad that I did. I was like, no, because now I have to get up and I have to go live through this. And it was like, I didn't want to. I felt just foggy. I felt alone. I cried every day, like so much, just so much. Of course, I never let anybody see me cry because I'm a proud idiot and I don't like crying in front of people, but I did a lot. I just didn't feel right. I mean, I looked out and it just, nothing felt right. I felt dead, but like there. I don't know how to explain it. It was like I was there, but I just wasn't there. And it sucks. And I always kind of have like this burning feeling in my gut. I don't know if you guys get that, but like that's how I can describe it. It's just like this feeling of just burning, like somebody lit a fire in your stomach and it's just boiling all the way out. And it's just what I always felt like. And that would always turn into really angry, where I just get so mad and just put a punch in. Or it would turn into emotionalness and I would cry like an idiot. That was all of 2012 for me. 2012 was the worst year by far. I think I finally just started to overcome it all around like the beginning of 2013. And the reason was because I started exercising, started losing weight, eating healthier. Oh, and I found somebody that I could talk to that actually understood and like totally got everything that I was saying. I could say something that I wasn't even sure about, and he'd be like, I totally understand what you mean. I get you. And it was nice. It was just basically what I needed, because I, like I said, I'm a proud person and I don't talk to people. I don't talk to like my family. Not that I can't, because I know that I can, because I have the best family in the world and they would listen and understand. But I did it because I didn't want to. It's a right thing. Yeah, I found somebody that actually related, like really related to me, and you know, like basically knew exactly what I was going through, and it felt good to know that it wasn't crazy, or I was crazy, but I wasn't crazy by myself. I wasn't alone. That, and I could just basically talk to him about it, anything, everything, and he would listen. So basically, I finally just opened up to somebody, and it wasn't just anybody. Like, you can't just go to like some random stranger on the street like, yo, I'm sad, make me happy, it's not gonna happen. He listened and he helped me get through it. So that's good. And because of that, I've been more open, like try to talk to people about it, like the way I feel, if I'm not feeling good, if I feel, you know, the way I did, or even slightly anywhere near the way I did, because that was the worst ever. For an example, I had an emotional mental breakdown to my sister the other night when we couldn't find our dog. I wasn't here, but I knew he was gone, and like it was like, okay, well, we'll find him, whatever. But like as soon as I got home and I realized, wow, he's really gone, it hit me really, really just overwhelming, and I kind of lost myself, like I said in the beginning of this. Yeah, I was crying, I was like angry at myself for crying, and at the same time though, it just felt really good. And my sister is like, what do I do? Because she's my little sister and she doesn't really, I don't know. It's good to open up to people, so you guys definitely need to do that. Definitely, if you're going through anxiety or depression, you need to talk to somebody, open up to somebody, you know, let people know how you feel, because you're not alone. I know, I hate when people tell me that too, you're not alone. So annoying. But you're really not, and people do care, whether you think they do or not, people do care, and they want to help you. Basically, that's it. You just have to have a positive outlook when you're dealing with this kind of stuff. You just have to think, okay, it's going to get better, and yeah, it will come back, because it always does. It's going to. It's part of who you are now. You're never going to truly get rid of anxiety. Yeah, it's just so stupid. When life is so beautiful, and you have so much to live for, and you have so much stuff that, like, life is just so worth living for, basically. Talk to people and just open up, let people know how you feel, and that I guarantee that alone will make you feel so much better. And as much as I hate like anxiety and I'm terrible, I never want to deal with it again, it's like at the same point though, at the same time, I look back at myself and I do like it. I feel like I've changed a lot because of it. It's made me a better person. I feel like it's made me more understanding to people too, and it's made me like realize that even though people act, you know, absolutely fine, like they're not, they're probably hiding behind a mask. I don't judge people. I used to judge people a lot, and I think that I needed it, basically. I think that it was God putting me through something so that I could see what I was doing wrong and I could fix it, and I pretty much did. So basically now that I'm going through anxiety and something, there's obviously something wrong that I need to fix and find out, you know, solve the puzzle, basically, and I will, and it'll get better. Alright, so, and you guys just remember that God wouldn't put you through anything He knew that you couldn't handle. And if you're going through anxiety, you're dealing with anxiety or depression, there's a reason for it. There's always going to be a reason for it. And it's just your body, basically, your mind, yourself telling you, letting you know that something is wrong and that you need to find out what it is and fix it so that you can move on and be happy. So, you know, don't let it push you over the edge or let it get to you. Just try to stay happy and positive. Okay, so this video has dragged on for so long, and I'm so sorry. I feel like I've been rambling so long. So thank you guys for watching. My back hurts. Okay, so I'm going to end this video because my back hurts. You can follow me on Twitter at, I almost said Punkspiration, but I changed my Twitter name. It is now Ange, A-N-G, sevenfold, seven the number, fold. Hold your laundry. So thank you guys for watching again, and remember, beef jerky is good, meat is good, vegetarians. Okay, bye, pumpkin kisses. Bye. That was the longest video of my life.